Chapter 1, Working with Large and Small Numbers. In order to work with large and small numbers, it is important first to be able to work with fractions, and so we begin with a very quick review. Fractions can be added, subtracted, multiplied, and divided. In this section, however, we focus on multiplication and division of fractions. These operations are performed as follows. To multiply two fractions, a over b times c over d, we simply multiply the numerators of the fractions and the denominators of the fractions. Notice there's no need to find a common denominator. To divide the fraction a over b by the fraction c over d, we turn the division into multiplication. Instead of dividing by the fraction c over d, we instead multiply by the fraction d over c. This is called multiplying by the reciprocal, because the fraction d over c is called the reciprocal of the fraction c over d. Once we have the division written in terms of multiplication, we can use what we know about multiplying fractions to multiply these two fractions. We multiply the numerators, multiply the denominators. Just a recap. Notice that dividing by a fraction c over d is the same as multiplying by the reciprocal d over c. In general, dividing by a non-zero number d, which we could write as d over 1, it is the same as multiplying by the reciprocal of d, namely 1 over d. Example 1.1. Perform the indicated operations without using a calculator. Go ahead and pause this recording now. Work the parts of this example on your own first. Then continue playing the recording to see this example worked out. In this way, you can check your own understanding. Okay, let's go ahead and work Part A. In Part A, we're multiplying these two fractions together, and so we simply multiply the numerators of the fractions. We arrive at 8, and we multiply the denominators of these two fractions, and we arrive at 15. Okay, let's go ahead and do Part B. We're dividing 7/5 by 3. To work this problem, we need to think of 3 as a fraction. So we're taking 7/5 and we are dividing it by the fraction 3 over 1. Dividing by 3 over 1 is the same thing as multiplying by the reciprocal 1/3. When we perform the multiplication, we find we get 7 divided by 15. Now let's talk about simplifying fractions. A fraction can be simplified whenever the numerator and the denominator share a common factor. Factors are simply quantities that are multiplied. Let's consider this fraction. A and C are factors in the numerator. B and C are factors in the denominator. So you can see C is a common factor in the numerator and the denominator. In this case, the common factor C can be canceled out of the fraction because the fraction C over C is the same as 1 because C divided by C is 1. Let's look at this a bit more thoroughly. If I take this fraction, A times C divided by B times C, I can use multiplication to rewrite it as two fractions that are multiplied. When I do this, I'm separating out the fraction c over c, which is equal to 1. So really what we're doing is taking the fraction a over b, multiplying it by 1, which of course is a over b. Therefore, this fraction can be simplified down to this fraction. This process of simplifying fractions by eliminating all factors that are common to the numerator and the denominator is often referred to as reducing to lowest terms. Example 1.2. Perform the indicated operations and simplify. We'll do this one together. Let's look at Part A. Here we're multiplying two fractions together. So, of course, we simply multiply the numerators and multiply the denominators. We could physically multiply out all of these numbers. The result would be a fraction that has a large numerator and denominator. Simplifying that fraction would be a bit more cumbersome. A better approach at this point is to try and simplify this fraction first before doing the multiplication. Let's see how this is done. If we look at the numbers in the numerator and denominator currently, there are no common factors. However, 5 and 50 share a common factor of 5, 36 and 8 share a common factor of 4. So we can factor out all of these numbers that are currently in the numerator and denominator and then do some canceling. 36, I'm going to rewrite that as 4 times 9, and then there's the 5 that was already in the numerator. The 50, I'm going to rewrite that as 5 times 10, and the 8, I'm going to rewrite that as 4 times 2. Writing the numerator and denominator this way, we can see factors that can be canceled, the 4s and the 5s. What's remaining is a 9 in the numerator and factors of 10 and 2 in the denominator, which when multiplied give 20. So in this problem you can see we did our simplifying first, our canceling first, and then we performed our multiplication afterward. The resulting fraction is fully simplified because there are no common factors in the numerator and the denominator. Let's go ahead and look at part B. Here we're dividing the fraction 8/3 by the fraction 24/9. An easier way of looking at this is to rewrite the problem as follows using the division symbol. When we rewrite it this way, we can see that really what it is that we need to do is rewrite this problem with multiplication. Instead of dividing by 24/9, we instead multiply by 9/24. In other words, the reciprocal. To perform the multiplication, we multiply the numerators and we multiply the denominators. We could actually do the multiplication at this point, but again, the resulting fraction would have large numerator and denominator, and simplifying that fraction would be a bit cumbersome. So let's use the same approach we used in part A. Let's see if we can simplify this fraction first. If we look at the numbers that are in the numerator and denominator currently, we see 8 and 24 have a common factor of 8, 3 and 9 have a common factor of 3. So let's go ahead and factor these numbers first. 8, I'm going to leave as 8. 9 is 3 times 3. I'm going to leave the 3 alone, and I'm going to rewrite 24 as 8 times 3. Now we can see factors that can be canceled. The 8s, those 3s, and these 3s. So what's left? Although it doesn't look like it, there is actually a 1, a factor of 1 in both the numerator and the denominator. It's always there, even if we don't write it. So even if everything cancels out, there's still always a 1 in the numerator and the denominator. 1 divided by 1 is 1, and so this problem simplifies down to 1. Now let's look at part C. Here we're multiplying two fractions. In this case, the fractions involve variables, but the process is identical to what we've done above. To multiply these two fractions, we have to multiply the numerators and multiply the denominators. Again, if we did the multiplication right away, we would end up with a very messy fraction. It could be done, but simplifying it can be cumbersome. Let's go ahead and simplify the fraction first before multiplying. If I look at the numerical quantities, 6 and 24 share a common factor of 6, 5 and 15 share a common factor of 5. There are also factors of x and y in this fraction, and some of those may be, we may be able to cancel them as well. So let's go ahead and rewrite this out in factored form. I'm going to leave 6 as 6. X squared, that is x times x, that's what it looks like in factored form. 15 is 5 times 3. Y cubed in factored form is y times y times y. In the denominator, 5y, that is just 5 times y. 24 is 6 times 4. X cubed is x times x times x. Now we can see that there are factors that can be canceled. The 6s, the 5s. There are two factors of x in the numerator that can be canceled with these two factors of x in the denominator. There's a factor of y in the denominator that can be canceled with one factor of y in the numerator. This leaves us with one factor of 3 in the numerator and two factors of y in the numerator, which we can write as y squared. In the denominator, we have a factor of 4 and a factor of x. This fraction is in fully simplified form because the numerator and the denominator do not share any common factors.